Netflix's new Korean drama, Squid Game, is packed full of shocking and violent moments. And in this video, we'll be looking at the 10 most shocking moments. There are spoilers ahead, so consider this your spoiler alert. Number 10. The Game Continues. It's a year after the completion of the game, and the winner, Gi-hun, is on his way to Los Angeles to see his daughter. He has dyed his hair red and really seems to have put the events of the past year behind him, ready to move on with the rest of his life. However, his past comes rushing back to him when he sees a replay of his recruitment for the Squid Game, this time around with another desperate money seeker. Insistent on preventing the games from continuing, he confronts the new guy and even snatches the recruitment card from his hand, effectively making sure that the new guy does not participate in the game. We think some of us kinda thought that the game would end, considering that its originator was dead. So, seeing that the wheels were still in motion must have been a surprise. Number 9. The Hug of Death. Hell hath no fury like a woman scorned. When Min-yul promised Kok-soo that she would kill him if he ever betrayed her, he certainly didn't take her seriously, because he did exactly by refusing to let her join his team for the tug-of-war game. Min-yul and Kyok-soo are arguably two of the most offensive characters in the TV show, and they managed to escape death a number of times using their cunningness. So, a lot of people were happy to see them finally meet their death in the penultimate game. However, it still came as a shock to most people that Min-yul was able to keep her word, not minding that she'd have to give up her life in the process. Talk about unhinged! Number 8. Red Light, Green Light. Absolutely nobody was prepared for the intensity of Red Light, Green Light, not even the players. Brought in unconscious from different places around South Korea, the players wake up to find themselves in a prison-like dorm and masked men addressing them. They are told that all of them there are to compete for a prize money and all they have to do is win all 6 games. Also, anyone who doesn't pass any of the games will be eliminated. However, it's at this very first game, Red Light, Green Light, that both the audience and the players understand what the masked men really meant by getting eliminated. The massacre that happened, aided by a motion-sensitive robot, is a violent eye-opener and a taste of things to come. Number 7. Killed for an egg. Everything in the Squid Game is extreme, including being bullied for your lunch. All the players stand in line to get their lunch and are each given a bottle of soda and a hard-boiled egg, which is understandably not sufficient for grown adults. However, Kyok-soo and his gang decide to do something about it by cutting the line to collect seconds. Unfortunately, this meant that some people didn't get anything at all. Spurred by hunger-induced courage, one of the players who got nothing decides to confront Kyok-soo for his lunch, but gets himself beaten to death. What's worse is that the masked men are there, but don't do anything about it, and the dead man's share of the prize money is added to the jackpot. As a result, the players learn that killing one another is in their best interest. So, that night, there's a massacre, and we learn later that that was the plan of the organizers all along. Number 6. The Win. Without a doubt, everyone knew that Gi-hun, the protagonist, would win the game somehow. However, what we didn't know, and what probably came as a shock to most of us, is how it happened. Angered by all the atrocities that Sang-woo had made happen, Gi-hun seemed intent on killing Sang-woo, and not only because he wanted to win the prize money, but when it came down to it, he just couldn't go through with it, and so asked whoever was listening whether they could end the game there if they both agreed. Most of us would have thought that Sang-woo would agree to this or even try to pull another trick, considering all the antics he'd been up to. But he grabbed the knife that Gi-hun dropped and stabbed himself in the neck, after telling Gi-hun to use some of the money he wins to take care of his mother. Number 5. Ali's Death. Ali's death is certainly up there as one of the most painful deaths in the Squid Game. Without a doubt the purest character in the show, Sang-woo's betrayal of him hurt a lot of people and cemented Sang-woo as the major villain in the show in the minds of many viewers. Ali's death is just proof that sometimes good people finish last. Number 4. The Brother Reveal. Inspector Chun-ho snuck his way into the game as one of the masked men after getting a lead that suggested that his brother might be in there. Through the episodes, we see him gather information that will help him to find his brother. And in the penultimate episode, he manages to break into the frontman's office where he finds out that his brother actually won the games back in 2015. Believing that he had enough information to take down the organization, and with the frontman and his team on his tail, Chun-ho decides to go back home. Unfortunately, going back home is not as easy as coming was, and he eventually finds himself face to mask with the frontman. One thing leads to another, and the frontman takes off his mask, revealing himself to be Jung-ho's long-lost brother, In-ho. But that wasn't even as shocking as In-ho killing his brother without much hesitation. Number 3. Player 001 is alive. For the most part, people liked Player 001, an old man who, it seemed, was forced to participate in these games. What's not to like? So, there was some sadness when he was killed as part of the marble game. Or at least, we thought he was killed until the final season when it was revealed that he actually wasn't. And not only was he not killed, he was actually the brain behind the dastardly game, which explains why he was still alive despite losing the marble game. Though nothing could justify bringing people together to kill them, it's even worse when we hear that he did the whole thing and participated in the games because he needed some more excitement in his life. And even though he actually had a brain tumor that was killing him, nobody could muster up any form of sympathy for him at this point. Number 2. Sehbyuk's death. Although our first introduction to Sehbyuk is of her pickpocketing Ki-hun, and she is, for the most part, standoffish throughout the show, most of us come to like her as the show progresses. So, her death was actually heartbreaking for a number of people. But the shock came as a result of Sang-woo stabbing her to death even though she was already dying anyway. During the glass stepping stones game, she got a shard of glass stuck in her side when the whole thing blew up and she was already bleeding to death. There was really no need for Sang-woo to stab her, but he did, because he revels in that kind of thing. And number 1 on our list is the marble game. The reason this is number 1 is not just because of the deaths, but also how twisted the whole thing was. The players were asked to pick partners without being told what the game was about. It wasn't until they picked partners that they were told that they had to try to get all their partners' marbles and the partner without the complete set would be eliminated. Because most of the players picked people that they had some kind of relationship with, they had to be forced to pick between themselves and their partners. This game saw Sang-woo betray Ali, Ji-young sacrifice herself for Sehbyuk, and a husband commit suicide after having to watch his wife die. Really terrifying. Are there any moments that you think should have made it to this list? Please tell us in the comments section below. If you think you watched the movie with complete attention, here are 15 things you might have missed that say otherwise. Definitely watch that video next to test your Squid Game knowledge and attention to details. Bye for now, and see you over there. Netflix Master, out.